is to address an audience of more than 100 people with confidence, and of course he wants it to be a paid avenue. Please welcome our first speaker for the day, Toastmaster Raj Mehta, speech.
Have you seen my speech? Have you seen my speech? Have you seen my speech?
Yes.
Where is my speech? Where has it gone? I had written my speech on Friday in my office. Actually, the power had gone out and internet was also not working, and my boss had also gone home for working from home. Then I hand wrote my speech on a A4 size plain sheet. I had completed it, only titling was left. But where has it gone? Where? I have searched it everywhere. In my office bag, in my almirah, on my bed, on my sofas, in our kitchen, in our balconies, on my fridge, under the fridge, over on the TV, under the TV, even in the bathroom. I could not find it. I went to my wife and asked, "Suman, have you seen my speech?" "Speech? What speech?" "I have to deliver speech tomorrow. I had written it in my office. I'm not finding it." She said, "So, tomorrow you have a Toastmaster meeting. And you will be delivering the speech tomorrow." "I haven't seen it," she said. After some time, she said, "Raj, do one thing. Take a pause, take some rest, meditate, think over it, and you will find it." She pushed me to our bedroom, made me sit on the resting chair, gestured me for meditation, closed my eyes gently, and went back to the kitchen. After some time, she came back rushing and said, Raj, I got an idea. Let's go to the sale of ladies' dresses, and it is the last day. It's in Aga Khan Bhavan. Let's go there. I'm sure you will find some idea because you will have the glance of many beautiful ladies there." I don't know from where I got motivated. Maybe from the thought that I would be among many beautiful ladies. I accompanied her. Believe it or not, at the sale point, I saw many very beautiful ladies' dresses, but not the ladies themselves. We came back, she with a handful of purchases, and I empty-handed. By the time we returned home, my son had already come back from school. Sad as I was, I asked him, "Shivansh, have you seen my speech?" "No, Daddy." And he went to his room for changing. I followed his footsteps. I asked him, "Please try to remember. You might have seen it somewhere in the morning. I need it very badly." Perhaps he was overloaded with homework, or perhaps he was tired and sweating heavily, or perhaps he had not expected me at home. He burst, "I haven't seen your speech. You always talk about your speech, Toastmaster meetings. Have you ever asked me about my health, my studies, my future? Have you ever?" It was more than enough. I had to flee. It was a hot day and I was tired. As I laid down on the bed, I slept. I was made to get up at around 8 p.m. by my daughter, Rubal. When I got up, she asked me why I was sleeping at that odd hour. Then I told her the whole story. She said in a soothing voice, "Oh, Pa, don't worry. It's only a speech. We will find it together. We will search it. Even if we don't find it, you can write it again. Or you can deliver an extempore speech. Or at the worst situation, you can skip the meeting." Her words gave me some solace. We had dinner, and after that I sat down for writing a speech afresh. But I could not collect my thoughts and had to give up the writing in between. Then I decided that I would deliver an extempore speech, to which Rubel's tongue stopped. My dear friends, I have not yet found my speech. How could I? Because later on I remembered that it was left in my drawer of my office table. But I found me through the eyes of my family members. My wife, who always wanted a company of mine with her. My son, who looks up to me for guidance and involvement. And my daughter, who always finds positivity in everything. Today, I have not delivered a speech here. I have spoken my family's heart about me. Go and search your speech before you deliver your next speech anyway. All the best.